Hello, my name is Zach Gibbs, and I'm a content developer within education services inside Juniper Networks. And today we will be going through the data center filter-based forwarding firewall learning byte. All right, so here is the topology, and in here we have a few different devices. We have router L1, router L2, which are normal router leaves, and then service leaf, service L1, which is a service leaf. And then we have the DC firewall, or DCFW, which is our firewall for our data center. And with this learning byte, we're going to be focusing on the firewall configuration, so it's DCFW. And keep in mind that I have done other learning bytes that go over the router L1 and router L2 configuration, as well as the service L1 configuration. And there will be another learning byte that goes over the verification of this whole filter-based forwarding in a data center scenario. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump to the CLI and get this going. All right, so here is the firewall device. We won't be doing too much configuration or really any configuration here. I've pre-done that configuration because this is a lot to go through with all this configuration, but there is some things we do need to look at. And so with that being said, let's go ahead and jump back to the topology to have a look and see where we're at. All right, so here's the topology. We have previously configured router L1 and router L2 and service leaf L1. We configured the inspect VRF on both of those, or all three of those, or I guess it's both, just two, and the secure VRFs on the service leaf L1 and router leaf L2, connected those together with the correct route targets, configured the correct VNIs, configured the EVPN protocol to export routes as type 5 routes. And so the routing is being shared, and we'll show the verification of that later. But right now we want to focus on the DCFW, which is the data center firewall. And here you can see it connects into service leaf 1. We have two different interfaces, GIGI 002.91 and GIGI 002.992. Those interfaces connect into, the 991 connects into the inspect VRF, and the 992 connects into the secure VRF on the service leaf. And so we'll look at that configuration and see what's going on. And we'll look at the Bgp groups, the pairings. We configure that with service leaf 1. So let's go ahead and jump back to the firewall. And so here, let's first look at the Bgp groups. And you can see that we do have two groups. Recall that 10.991, or rather the 10.91.91.2, is the inspect VRF on the service leaf, and 10.92.92.2 is the secure VRF on the service leaf. So we can look at the routes, see what we're receiving. And you can see here we have the host 1 route, the host 2 route, and then the loopback interfaces for the VRFs. Those are being sent, and that's good. That's what we want to do. And so with that, let's see what we're sending the service leaf VRFs. Let's see, just specify the neighbor. And you can see we're sending them a default route, and that's exactly what we want to do, because that'll help attract the traffic in the VRFs towards the firewall. And so we can look at what we're sending the secure VRF, and again, the default route. Now, that default route is just something that's configured here locally as a static route with a next hop of discard. So if there's no specific host route, then, and traffic comes in and matches something else, it's just going to discard it. And that's what we want to do. We only want to be passing around traffic for specific routes. And here, recall that if we look at BGP routes, we can see here we have routes for host 1 and host 2. So we won't be discarding that traffic. If any other traffic shows up here, it's going to discard it, because that's what the next hop for the default route is. And so, okay, so what else do we want to show? We want to show security zones. There we go, the security zones. Okay, we can see here that GIGI 002.991 is part of the inspect zone, and GIGI 002.992 is part of the secure zone. And for host inbound traffic, we're only permitting BGP traffic, and that's because we need to have BGP pairings with the service leaf from the firewall. So that makes perfect sense. And then what else would be good to show? Okay, so the security policies. Let's jump into that. We're going to need to edit some of those security policies, because we'll see how they look currently. They're currently set up, but they're not set up correctly. Okay, so from zone secure to zone. No, we don't want to do that. We want to do inspect to secure. Now recall, it's going to be coming in the inspect interface or the inspect zone, coming from the inspect VRF and then to the secure zone, to the secure VRF on the service leaf. And so we have some security policies set up, but we've set up to permit ICMP and block and log or deny and log SSH. And we want to flip that around. Remember, we're not going to allow ICMP, but we're going to allow SSH. So let's just go ahead and delete those policies. And we'll say policy, edit policy, allow dash SSH, source, set match, source address, host one. Now this, it's already, host one is already configured in the address book. Destination address, host two, application, Junos dash SSH. And we're going to set, then permit. We're just going to permit that traffic. So that looks good. And we're going to specify a new policy called block ICMP. We're going to say match source address host one, destination address host two, application. I'm going to say Junos ICMP all. And then we're going to say deny or set then. Let's say reject log. I'm going to say set then log session init. So the session initialization. Now, one thing to look at with this is only coming from the inspect zone to the secure zone. So if host two attempts to initiate traffic to host one, it won't even attempt to set up the session. We don't even have it set up to log those attempts or whatever, but at least with this regards, we do have it set up to permit the SSH traffic from host one, host two, and block ICMP traffic and log that. Now, if something else, say it's some sort of mail protocol or FTP or something else comes through, it'll just get silently rejected or discarded because the default policy on an SRX is to silently discard without logging. So keep that in mind. And so I think we're good there. Let's go ahead and commit that and exit to operational mode. And then we can verify this. And so we have the firewall configured. And so next we'll jump to verification. All right, this brings us to the end of this learning byte. Here we demonstrate how to configure the firewall with regards to data center filter-based forwarding. So as always, thanks for watching.
Visit the Juniper Education Services website to learn more about courses. View our full range of classroom, online, and e-learning courses. Learning paths, industry segment and technology specific training paths. Juniper Networks Certification Program, the ultimate demonstration of your competence. And the training community, from forums to social media. Join the discussion.